Hi, thank you for your interest in the block ransomware and backup application developed by xSecuritas. In this video, we will show how to create a protected folder that is unaffected of ransomware and how it is automatically backed up. First, we explain how to block ransomware, malware, and then the procedure for automatic backup. When some program attempts to create, delete, modify or rename files in the protected folder, block ransomware first checks whether the program is already allowed. For your convenience, we have predefined programs that are commonly used in day-to-day uses. If an allowed program tries to save a file to a protected folder, it will be allowed to save it and will also automatically backup after saving. If you try to save a file to the protected folder with a denied program, this save operation will fail. If the program is neither allowed program nor denied program, application will prompt the user to decide whether to allow or to deny. In the displayed window, the user can choose whether to allow or deny the program. In this case, the ransomware protection folder is designated as the desktop and documents folders. In other words, ransomware cannot compromise this folder. Also, if files are modified or created in the desktop or documents folder, it will be automatically backed up to the backup folder on drive D. Let's test it now. I will save the summary.docs file on the desktop as summary-modify.docs after changing the contents using the Office program. Summary modified docs file has been successfully saved to your desktop folder. After about 30 seconds after saving the file, this file is automatically saved in the backup folder. When a backup is in progress, a notification window will be displayed in tray. Now, let's copy the files to the testful folder on the desktop. You can see that the four files have been successfully copied to the testful folder. Likewise, after about 30 seconds, a notification window informs you that this file has been backed up. Now let's try saving the file using a program that is neither an allowed program nor a denied program. The save text program, which may or may not be safe, will attempt to save the deny.txt file on the desktop. You are now asked whether you want to allow or deny this program. If you allow it, the file will be saved. If you deny it, the file will not be saved. Since you denied here, you will see a denied notification window. Now, once you have saved the file in the protected folder, let's examine how it was backed up. We set the backup root folder to drive D, therefore, we need to access the backup folder on drive D in Explorer. Now you can see the folder named C drive. The backup folder structure is organized into a structure very similar to the original file folder. So, continue to explore. You can find the backed up files in desktop folder, which is located under User, Admin. The name of the backup file is appended with the year, month, day and hour, minute, and second in the original file name showing the time of backup. Files in the backup folder cannot be created, deleted, or modified. That is, all access is denied. This is to prevent users from accidentally deleting files, and also to protect backup folders from viruses and ransomware. Of course, after setting permissions in the main application, you can modify or delete files in the backup folder. As you can see on the screen, you can now rename or delete files in the backup folder. What happens after the application is terminated? Once the application is closed, you cannot create, modify or delete files in the protected folder even if the program is allowed. Files in the protected folder can be opened but open for read-only and cannot be modified. How is it? We are confident that you can use this product to protect your important files from ransomware, virus, malware, as well as prevent you from accidentally corrupting your files. Thanks you for watching.